It seems like a lot of people want to tell you what to do during Q4. Well, in this video, I want to tell you what not to do during Q4. There's certain things that if you do it during Q4, you're actually going to be hurting yourself. And I wouldn't be doing my job as an FBA coach if I didn't tell you the things that you should stay away from, the things you should avoid doing during Q4. Because if you avoid these things, you'll be able to find more profits, make more sales, make more money. Q4 is all about the increased sales, and I want to help increase your sales, increase your disbursements. So here are the things, seven things not to do during Q4. Number one, obsessively check your pending sales. Okay, don't do that. Sure, it's fun every once in a while to check your sales for the day, see where you are, but a lot of times we can waste our time checking our pending sales. Now, it is kind of a fun, in fact, there's probably even a psychological dopamine hit in our brain when we see all these new sales come in. We see like, you know, three or four pages of pending sales and things like that. But don't obsessively look at your sales all throughout the day. There's more profitable things for you to be doing, more profitable things in your Amazon FBA business to spend your time on than checking your sales. I usually check the sales once a day, maybe twice a day, and for me, that's good. For you, maybe you need to be a little bit more, but don't obsessively check it. So that's tip number one, not to do. Number two, this is what you shouldn't do. Implement a brand new strategy or try selling in a brand new category. That's something you should not do during Q4. You've had, 9 months of during first quarter, second quarter, and third quarter to try things that are new, to start selling in new categories. This is the time, Q4 is the time to maximize what you currently know and put it into action. If you spend a lot of time learning new things, learning a new strategy, learning about selling a new category, I think you're going to be missing out on other opportunities to be able to maximize your profit, maximize your time. So don't try new things right now. Make the most of what you know right now. And then when, you know, the Christmas selling season is over, January comes, you can take the funds that you've made during Q4, invest it in some new courses or a new book, new strategies to learn, and then put them into action. So that's number two. Tip number three of what not to do during Q4 is this. Stop sending an inventory. Stop sending inventory to Amazon FBA. There are people who during Q4 think, well, you know what? It's like 10 days until Christmas. If I send it into Amazon now, it's not going to get there in time for Christmas sales. I'm just going to stop sending in inventory. No, sales continue after Christmas. There are people who didn't get what they wanted. They were going to want to buy your items, so send it to Amazon. There's going to be people who on Christmas Day got Amazon gift cards. They're going to want to use that money to buy your items. So continue feeding the beast. Continue shipping items to Amazon. You want to be able to have those items there for after Christmas, for January. If you're sending in toys for Q4, kids have birthdays all year round. You want to be sure that they buy your items. So continue to ship items to Amazon. There's no cutoff. There might be a cutoff day for you to have your items to be able to be live on Amazon in time for a Christmas sale, but That's just for you to know for Christmas. There's still going to be more Christmas. There's still going to be more sales after Christmas. So that's number three. Number four, what not to do during Q4. Blindly lower your prices. Now, most of the time during Q4, what I've experienced is that prices go up. They don't go down. Supply is starting to go down because people are buying these items at an increased rate. The velocity of sales is increasing, and so with that usually comes an increase in prices. If you're looking at your items and you're like, I need to lower my prices a little bit to get the next sale, you're going to be losing out on money, because if you just blindly lower your prices, you're going to miss out on the profits, the ROI that you have prepared for to get that might just come a few days later or another week, depending on where you are in Q4. So don't blindly lower your prices. I always check Camel, and Keepa, look at the sales history, the pricing history. If you want free training on how to understand Camel, and Keepa, they're both free programs that you can use to help you with your Amazon sales. But to learn Camel, you can go to fulltimefba.com/readcamel. And to be able to learn and understand about Keepa, fulltimefba.com/readkeepa. A lot of the items that you might be selling on Amazon might have history that goes back to last year's Q4. And you can see what it was selling for, what the sales rank was doing, how high it was priced at that time, so you can kind of know what to expect this year. So don't blindly lower your prices. Tip number five of what not to do during Q4. Spend time comparing yourself to others. That's what you should not be doing. There's a lot of times where we can go to Facebook and you can see, oh, there's just a picture of this guy. He's got like five carts full. It's like this whole little train of carts. And he's like, oh, I just scored all this stuff. Or people are posting screenshots of their sales for the day or their sales for the week or sales for the month or even sales for the year. And they're like, you know, look at what's possible. And I know a lot of times people post that to encourage other people to know what's possible. But a lot of people also take the flip side of that and they think, I'll never be there. I'm never going to be able to do that. That's not going to be able to be me. You need to understand something. Where you are in your Amazon business is completely different than where someone else is. And so you shouldn't expect the exact same results. So don't compare yourself with other people. The best person to compare yourself with is who you were yesterday. Where you were last month, where you were last year. That's a good person to compare yourself with and to see where you're growing. And, you know, encouraging yourself with the things that you're growing, learning what mistakes you've made in your failures so that you can do better next year. So just compare yourself with who you were in the past. That's going to help you out in the future. So don't compare your chapter 2 to someone else's chapter 8. We're all in this business at different points, different references, different perspectives, different life circumstances. And so we just need to understand that don't compare yourself to other people. Okay, number 6, a tip of what not to do during Q4 is this. Chase the hot toys. Go buy all the hot toys. The magazines tell you what to buy. Go get those hot toys. No. Please don't do that. A lot of times people assume that when the toy companies or the stores, Amazon has this, they come out with a list. What are going to be the hot toys of the year? And a lot of times they do this because they're like, okay, this is what we want to be the hot toys. And they're trying to make a good guess of what they think might be the most popular toys. But here's the deal. The stores that create these lists, they do it to make sales. And they're going to make sure that they have enough of those items for the demand that they expect. Sure, every once in a while there's going to be a hit toy, a hit item that's going to be the hot toy that's going to be really hard to find, that no amount of preparation could make the store ready for the kind of demand that they're going to get. But that's really, really rare. Most of the time, 99% of the time, if a toy says it's going to be hot, they're going to have plenty in stock for you to buy. So don't chase the hot toys. What I do instead is I look for accessories that are connected to the hot toys. I look for items that are connected to whether it's the same character, the same television show, the same whatever it is, if there's something connected to it, I look at what the hot toy is and I see what are things that are connected to that that I could see if it's profitable. I know one year there was this this smart zoo. And there was this, big, huge zoo, and there had all these little smart animals. Now, the store said that the smart zoo, that was going to be the hot toy for the year. And so a lot of people tried to buy those, ended up losing money, maybe breaking even on Amazon, trying to sell what they thought was going to be a hot toy. But it turns out that one of the hot toys for me was one of the little animals that went to the smart zoo. It was a little bit harder to find. It was a little bit of a short print. They made a bunch of different animals, and it turned out for some reason the monkey, out of all the animals in the zoo, we were able to buy for like $5 and sell for $20. And we probably sold 50 to 100 of those monkeys. They were really annoying and they sang a really annoying song, but it was profitable, so we dealt with it. So yeah, it was Mary the Monkey. That was the hot toy. Right now, that's actually like priced as an add-on item. It's not profitable right now, but it was profitable in Q4 past because it was connected to the big hot toy. So it was something that we looked at. So stay away from the hot toys, but use that knowledge to your advantage to find items that are profitable that other people aren't looking for. So that's it. And then tip number seven of what not to do during Q4. Neglect your family and friends. Now, this is not ever something that we do consciously. This is not something we ever decide to do, but a lot of times during Q4, with the opportunities for profit, the opportunities for sourcing, the opportunities for sales, we sometimes forget our loved ones. We forget our family. We don't spend the time with our kids that we need to, with our spouse, with our friends, and we kind of get into this little hole. And I know a lot of us feel safe in that hole. It's a safe little internet hole where we're doing our own little thing and we're, sourcing and we're selling stuff. But if you spend way too much time with your business and neglect your family or your friends, that's going to hurt you in the long run. That no amount of profit, no amount of money that you can make online can repair. So don't neglect your family. Don't neglect your friends. Be sure you make that they understand that they are a priority in your life, not just by words, but by actions. So those are the seven things that you should not be doing during Q4 that will help you in the long run, in your personal life, in your business life. And I know I've seen that in my own life, and I just wanted to help you out with that. So stay away from those things during Q4. That's all the time we have for today. Thank you so much for watching. If you are wanting more training help about Q4, you can check out our whole Q4 playlist on YouTube, fulltimefba.com/Q4 playlist, where you can find plenty of videos, free training, all about helping you maximize your time and your money during Q4. And if you like this video, you can scroll down, give us a thumbs up, you can leave a comment, and if you want to know about any of the links that we talked about in this video, you can click see more at the bottom. Look at the description. You'll see those links and you'll be able to go right to where you're wanting to go. Anyway, have a great day. God bless. And I'll see you at fulltimefba.com. Bye.